We're excited to share some of the reasons why our sustainability efforts are rated among the best in the country. We'll cover some highlights and just some of the ways to get involved. We'll start with our efforts to use sustainable energy sources and reduce greenhouse gas pollution. UNH Durham has about 20,000 people during the academic year. That's about the size of Keene or Portsmouth, New Hampshire. So it requires a lot of energy to heat and light our buildings. In 2005, UNH's Energy Task Force was created to help guide reductions in energy use, energy cost, and greenhouse gas emissions on campus. It includes students, faculty, staff, and university administrators. It's a great opportunity to get involved. In 2006, UNH signed on to the Climate Commitment, joined by hundreds of other US campuses. It commits us to reaching carbon neutrality and requires UNH to track and publicly report its carbon footprint. It also requires us to maintain an up-to-date climate action plan known as WildCap, which the Energy Task Force stewards. WildCap is designed to guide UNH's climate action efforts for the next 5+ years. Thanks to committed climate action planning, UNH cut its footprint more than 60% between 2001 and 2019. And in 2021, WildCap was updated to include a new set of ambitious goals and strategies, including a 75% carbon footprint reduction by 2030. We have learned we can be ambitious and practical. For example, our campus power plant is a cogeneration plant. Cogeneration is the process of producing electricity and heat simultaneously through burning gas, and then capturing the heat from that process that would have otherwise been wasted. This process is 35% more efficient than the most efficient natural gas power plants built today, cutting cost and our carbon footprint. We're also proud to use mostly renewable energy to power our campus. In 2009, UNH partnered with Waste Management, which runs Turnkey Landfill in Rochester, to harvest methane gas that is naturally produced by the landfill. UNH processes this gas on-site, then sends it to the campus through the Ecoline pipeline to be burned in the cogen power plant. The processed landfill gas is functionally similar to natural gas, so it allows us to displace natural gas that we would otherwise burn. This processed landfill gas provides 70% of all campus energy needs. In addition to producing energy more sustainably, UNH is committed to using energy more sustainably. For example, we have a thermal energy storage tank being built near Philbrook Dining Hall that will allow us to produce and store chilled water at night when there is less demand on the electrical grid and discharge it during the day to reduce daytime use of our cooling equipment. This thermal battery will reduce spikes in our demand that put strain on critical infrastructure and result in greater emissions. UNH also established a Green Revolving Loan Fund in 2009. This fund allows us to invest in energy efficiency projects that reduce energy use across campus, such as insulation, LED lighting, and an ice-making system at the Whittemore Arena that significantly reduces the energy and water needed to make ice. These renewable initiatives are great at reducing air pollution. Equally important, they generate financial savings that we can reinvest in energy projects and protect human health. That is why our UNH energy systems are great examples of sustainability.